Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today we discuss what is NASAMS, National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, and why Indian government is interested in it. The National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, NASAMS, is a medium-range, network-centric air defense system designed and developed jointly by Raytheon and Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace, primarily for the Royal Norwegian Air Force, RNOF. The system can be deployed to identify, engage, and destroy aircraft, helicopters, cruise missiles and unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, as well as protect high-value assets and mass population centers against air-to-surface threats. The missile system is in service with the RNOF, the Dutch Army, the Spanish Army and the U.S. National Capital Region, Finland, and an undisclosed nation. Raytheon and Kongsberg entered into a 10-year agreement in June 2015 to expand their partnership on NASAMS until 2025. NASAMS 2, an upgraded version of the NASAMS, uses new radars and 12 missile launchers for quicker identification and destruction of the targets. The upgraded system has been in service since 2007 and ordered by a number of countries, including Norway, Finland, and the Netherlands. NASAMS design and features. The NASAMS air defense system features network-centric, open architecture that provides increased survivability against electronic countermeasures. The missile system can engage 72 targets simultaneously in active and passive modes. The primary weapon of the system is AIM-120 AMRAAM. Raytheon MPQ-64F1 Sentinel high-resolution, 3D pencil beam surveillance radar is fitted to the NASAMS to detect and track the targets. The missile system is also fitted with AMRAAM launchers and a passive electro-optic, EO, and infrared, IR, sensor, hard real-time communication network and an embedded and standalone mission planning tool. NASAMS missile tests. The Spanish Army successfully conducted a live-fire exercise of the NASAMS with 4 AMRAAMs in November 2008. A tactical live-fire exercise of NASAMS was conducted by the RNOF in June 2011. The air defense system successfully test-fired AIM-9X Sidewinder short-range air-to-air missile in 2011. The RNOF conducted a test-firing of ground-based Evolved Sea Sparrow missile, ESSM, from the NASAMS in July 2012. Multi-missile launch capabilities of the NASAMS. The NASAMS is equipped with 3 multi-mission launchers, each carrying up to 6 ready-to-fire missiles inside the protective canisters. It can be carried on truck and rail. The system features a 360-degree defense capability and is suitable for day and night, all-weather operations. Command and control unit. The NASAMS is fitted with a fire distribution center, FDC, command and control unit to perform the battle management command, control, communications, computers, and intelligence, BMC4I, functions. It is also used for data link management, track identification, and correlation, friendly protection, jam strobe triangulation, threat evaluation, weapon allocation, and kill assessment. The FDC and radars are connected using Link 16, JRE, Link 11, Link 11B, LAPI and ATDL-1 data links. Why Indian government is interested in it? Well, NASAMS is a lower-tier defense additional capability against threats such as cruise missiles, aircraft, and drones, and nowhere similar in capabilities to top-tier missiles like MIRSAM and S-400. Also is quite cheaper. NASAMS is a combat-proven missile that demonstrated operational flexibility, especially in taking down low-cost targets like subsonic cruise missiles and armed drones. Use of MIRSAM and S-400 air defense system will be overkill to take down such low-cost platforms and most likely will be reserved for high-value targets like AWACS, fighter jets and mid-air refuelers. NASAMS mostly likely will be acquired as short-term gap-fill measure to replace older Russian air defense systems and to also allow India to study and develop so that it can be adapted to develop NASAMS-like air defense system indigenously by doing further improvisation to its QRSAM or be used as a stopgap measure until local development is concluded. DRDO for long has been rumored to be working on the development of a cruise missile defense system which can provide lower-tier air defense system to all major cities in India instead of requiring the deployment of expensive top-tier air defense system which can be deployed to guard high-value targets. Most of the subsonic long-range cruise missiles likely to be used against India are cheaper to develop and can be fired in bulk and in swarm-style attack, not specifically every time at a high-value targets within its range, but that doesn't mean no interception should take place. Use of really expensive higher-tier air defense system like MRSAM and S-400 will be overkill and also criminal wastage of resources. Lower-tier air defense systems specifically developed to handle threats such as cruise missiles and drones will come as a major boost to India's air defense capabilities, and it is unlikely India is going to procure NASAM's air defense system in large quantities, and it is most likely it will be substituted later with Indian-made system.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.